The universe is the mysterious creation of a vast intelligence. The origin of the world and life is beyond human understanding. The Vedas describe how consciousness is transformed into energy and matter. This process of creation and becoming is going on today, right now. This is not a theory or a religious doctrine. With these keys of understanding, you can see it for yourself. I sit before the final gate. I wait. After an interminable interval, it opens, revealing the zero point. Namaste. So, what do we mean by the zero point? The zero point is the bindu. The bindu. This is a bindu. But the zero point is the original bindu. It is a point, a dimensionless, abstract entity with no measurement, no space or time, no way to determine inside, outside, this, that, self or other. No differences, no boundaries, nothing to delineate a change. It is the one. It is the only one that can be. And this is the final realization. There cannot be anything beyond this. So how does this work? First, there is the zero, the nothing. Then, the zero is reflected in another zero. Zero times zero is not zero, as you have been told, at least not in transcendental calculus. Zero times zero is infinity. So this is the infinity. This is the appearance of duality, but because we're talking about two zeros, there actually isn't any duality. One zero is Nirguna Brahman, Brahman without any qualities. The other zero is Saguna Brahman, Brahman with all qualities. There is actually no difference between the two. Just the Nirguna Brahman is the actuality, the reality, and the Saguna Brahman is the appearance, the illusion, Maya. Now, why do I say that this is the ultimate realization? Well, on a personal level, I've tried everything else, and nothing else is as high as this. And on a philosophical level, as I said, the absolute must be without boundaries. Now, the only thing that can be without boundaries is a point. A point is an infinitesimal abstract entity. We learn in geometry that there are an unlimited number of points on a line. But how do you distinguish one point from another? They're all the same. So there's nothing to distinguish one point from another point. All points are the same, which means there's only one point. So this is the actual oneness. Not a cosmic consciousness. What a lame idea, actually. That's the Vishnu level. Beyond that is the Shiva level, Shiva Shakti, the fundamental duality, the two zeros that multiply together
to create infinity. Now, infinity is another strange concept. I'm not talking about the mathematical infinity or the infinity of the philosophers. I'm talking about the actual infinity, the one that we experience every single day. And of course, I'm talking about awareness. Awareness and the absolute being behind it. Before you can have awareness, you have to have being. And once you have being and awareness, then only you can have consciousness. But even so, consciousness depends on duality. So there has to be an object for consciousness to be aware of. And this is the Maya. This is the Shakti. This is the Saguna Brahman. So the point here, pun is intentional, is that self-realization is not a kind of razzle-dazzle, big production, you know, angels coming out of the sky with trumpets and all of that. That's not self-realization. Well, maybe in the early stages, very early stages. But in the final stage, it becomes very, very subtle. Infinitely subtle. And finally, there is only silence. So when I started out to make this video, it was because of a realization I had. Of course, that's the origin of all these videos, because I have a principle. I never talk about anything unless I've experienced it. And we spoke about that in the very beginning in this series on integrity, being integrity. Being integrity means you only talk about those things that are part of your being, not stuff you think about, not stuff you saw somebody else do or heard somebody else talk about or read in a book someplace, but those things that you have experienced yourself. And then for several days, I had to put off making the video because, well, first of all, I had to verify this is the real thing. And the other thing is I had to come up with a way of talking about it. How do you talk about nothing? I mean, I know people who can talk about nothing all day long. But I mean, really, how do you talk about a nothing which cannot even become something? So anything I say about this is wrong. Anything I could say is only words, only symbols. What I'm really talking about is an experience, a unique experience that only begins with emptiness. See, when one goes into emptiness, this is also called the seventh jhana in Buddha's teaching. The seventh jhana is nothingness, emptiness. And actually, emptiness is more than nothingness. Nothingness is in relation with somethingness. So even if you go into nothingness, there's still something that's going into nothingness. Who is aware of the nothingness? But in real emptiness, there's nobody to be aware. In real emptiness, there is no possibility of any becoming. There is no possibility of any thingness, thisness, or thatness. It's really hard to describe. In fact, the way that Buddha describes it is by negation. He says, in that state, there is no becoming. There is no intention. There is no desire. There is no ignorance. but there is no knowledge either. Because all these things are defined in terms of each other, huh? Somethingness and nothingness, thisness and thatness, knowledge and ignorance. But in the ultimate state of emptiness, there is no distinction, there is no duality. So these terms do not apply. It simply is what it is. But even that's wrong, because it really isn't. So how am I going to talk about this? I can only say that once you experience this point, this bindu, the zero point, the nothingness, everything else loses its flavor. That after you experience this, there's no way that you can come out into the world and enjoy and play around. It alters your whole perspective in a very subtle way that, once again, is very hard to describe. It was once one experiences the ultimate, everything else becomes less valuable, less interesting. Or, to put it the other way, more undesirable, more unsatisfactory. And one realizes that even consciousness itself is actually suffering. Because consciousness is impermanent, unsatisfactory, and not self. It has to be, because consciousness is of the other. If I'm conscious, let's say, of this phone, it's because I am myself and the phone is other. I'm the subject and the phone is the object. But if I am in a space where there is no subject, how can there be any object? So how can there be any consciousness? See, this is the point at which words fail. Ideas, concepts, even our vaunted ontology fails, and all expression becomes impossible. But then I maintain, it is possible to experience. How is that? Well, if you let the mind settle for a long time, and if you master the three stages of ordinary consciousness, waking, dreaming, and deep sleep, and their root, the turiya, then there's a chance that you can glimpse what is beyond it. The turiyatita. Turiyatita is that stage which is beyond consciousness itself. Now, very few people talk about this. Ramana Maharshi, Nisargadatta, and maybe just a few others barely mention it. Because this is such an elevated topic, this is such a high state, that really the only people who get to experience it at all are the jivanmuktas, those who are liberated in this very life, for whom this is the last lifetime, and they're leaving this world never to return. Well, who would want to return? See, most people, when they leave their body, touch on this zero state, this zero point, which is actually Shiva or Brahman, Nirguna Brahman. They are dragged, kicking and screaming, into this state. And then what's the first thing they do? Well, they desire to be born again. They desire to have consciousness. They desire to have a body and senses and activities. And so they manufacture themselves another body. Maya, Shakti, is very happy to grant their desires. That's her purpose. When someone is in the state of Shiva, she serves them. But because their desires are tinged with ignorance, well, all desires are tinged with ignorance, they get really just a bundle of suffering. And this is what the Buddha said so many times. Yeah, I could dig up a bunch of quotes and Pali and Sanskrit and so many other things. But I really just want to talk straight about my own experience of this. And it's very difficult to say something about nothing. So I'm going to end here. And just to let you know that this zero point is there. It's always there, in everything, everywhere, all the time. And it is actually the reality of everything, the final state. Om Tat Sat. Om Shakti Om.